Okay, so moving on, let me do a quick technologies overview. So there are a lot of hardware resources. Again, there is a lot of concern about, you know, do I have the hardware? No, should I go to the CDeep studio and do the recording? Okay, so not lot of it is not required. I mean, you can do the recording right on your own laptop using the webcam, or, you know, if you have a tripod and a camera, that's great because it will give you still. You can do it with a headphone or with the earbuds. You can do it with tablet. You can even write on paper. You can even write on paper, capture it using a mobile phone. And on the course website, we have actually uploaded a video which shows how to do this. And then there are recorders for mobile phones, etc. We have laptops and desktops for doing the editing. Again, there's a whole bunch of software for doing this. Hardware, the other thing that we have to worry about is the server space. You know, where are we going to upload the videos? Is the internet bandwidth enough, and so on. So as individuals, we probably don't have to worry too much, because you can say, okay, I'm going to host it on my own YouTube channel, or I'm going to host it on my Google Drive and I'm going to share the file with the students. As an institute, we have to think about these things a little more in depth. So institutional resources, for example, we have CDeep, which is the studios which are used for face-to-face classrooms. We can also create smaller studios. Many departments are thinking about creating smaller studios where faculty can go in a kind of a soundproofed environment. You know, if you catch, like for example, for this talk, I've had to turn off the fan. If I had kept the fan on, the noise of the fan would have been too much. And then, if you look at the platforms, like the three platforms that are, you know, very easily accessible right away at IIT Bombay are Moodle, which we are all familiar with, and then there is IIT Bombay X, and then there is BodhiTree. So for the platform, we have to do peak load calculation, saying, okay, if we put all the courses there in, and if all the students attack it at the same time, will the platform survive, and such things. And for meetings, once again, we have to provision for internet bandwidth. So all of this is going on. Now, if we look at software, which is something that individual instructor can control. Okay, so for video creation, there are several software. Okay, so there is OBS, which is a software that you can use, or you can do a simple screen recorder. Like for example, what I have done right now is that I have just switched on a screen recorder. So I downloaded one screen recorder software and I have just left it on. I've done nothing. At the start of the talk, I just switched it on. And by the time I finished with the talk, it will give me all the things that are there on the screen along with my voice. Okay, it won't give it to me with my video because I've used a very basic version. But there are other versions which can also capture the video and so on. So all of this can be done right away, right there on your laptop. Okay? Also, some people have found that it is useful for them to go to a Zoom meeting, irrespective of whether there are students or not, and do the lecture there and use their use the Zoom's feature to create the lecture. Okay, activity, again, many people are familiar with Moodle. Then there are other tools like Mentimeter for quickly taking a quiz, Padlet for sharing their ideas. Whole bunch of such tools exist, all of which are there on the course website. And then for delivering content, I've talked about BodhiTree, IIT Bombay X and Moodle. Again, video hosting, I've talked about YouTube, Drive. Kpoint is another commercial software, which is a video hosting service. Then for live interaction, again, there's a whole bunch of them. Zoom is there, BigBlueButton, so which can also be integrated with Moodle, and WebEx is what we are using. So for the details, you can visit the course page. The next slide in the PPT version of this is actually contains the criteria for comparing across these software. So let's say you want to choose video creation, that slide will tell you, okay, what are the features that you should look for and what are the things that will help you to make a decision on which one to use. So for the talk, I'm not going to go into that detail. That will become too overwhelming. So I'll just move on here and once again, ask for a feedback.